Pivot table enables us to create various tables by changing its fields on each area as a kind of interactive table. With pivot table, we can analyze and process complex data tables quickly. Take this raw data sheet as an example, which displays the sales of each branch of a brand. Now we can start to analyze its data. For example, we can analyze the total sales of each branch, the total sales of each item sold in each branch, the total sales of each item sold in each branch in each sales quarter. After knowing about the basic functions of pivot table from these examples, let's learn how to make it. Here are the steps. For example, we will work out the total sales of each item sold in each branch. First, select any cell with data in this table. Click the Insert tab in the functional area and click the Pivot Table button. In the pop-up Create Pivot Table dialog, the whole raw data table is selected as source range by default. You can also select other data sources manually. Here, we select New Worksheet and click OK. On the right of the new worksheet, we can see a pivot table pane, which consists of two parts, namely field lists and pivot table areas. The fields shown in the field list correspond to the table headers on the first row of the raw data sheet, and pivot table areas contains four areas, namely filters, calls, rows, and values. We generally place the fields containing numeric values into the values area and place non-numeric fields into the rows, calls, and filters areas. In this case, we need three fields: branch, item, and sales. Branch and item are non-numeric fields, and sales is a numeric field. First, drag branch onto the calls area, and we can see the branches are displayed in columns. Next, drag item onto the rows area, and the items are displayed in rows. Lastly, drag sales onto the values area, and the total sales of each item sold in each branch are calculated automatically. Is there a difference between placing a field in the rows area and the calls area? Let's swap the positions of these two fields and see what happens. Now we drag item onto the calls area and branch onto the rows area. Then they respectively appear on the corresponding areas in the pivot table. We can easily find that only the layout of this table is changed, but the calculated data remains the same. Therefore, we can choose to place a field in the rows area or calls area according to individual needs. In addition to data summation, what other statistical functions do pivot tables have? Right-click a cell with numeric values and click Summarize Values By in the shortcut menu. We can select Count, Average, Max, and so on. When we click Max, the pivot table will work out the maximum value of the total sales of each item sold in each branch. In addition, in the shortcut menu, we can click Show Values As to set the way values are shown, or click Percent of Grand Total to view the proportion of the total sales of each item sold in each branch. To view the total sales in different quarters, we can use the filters function. For example, we drag sales quarter on the filters area. Then a sales quarter drop-down button appears on the top of this pivot table. Click the drop-down button and choose a quarter to view the corresponding sales. If we want to learn more about the data source, we can double-click the cell with the left mouse button. Then all the data related to the cell will appear in a new worksheet. In conclusion, the pivot table in WPS Office meets diverse and detailed needs of analyzing and processing table data, helping us to save more time at work.